Here's a question before you leave. They tell you this compound is an alkane. They always will tell you the class of the compound. So what's the general formula of an alkane, everyone? Okay, right? Now, there are two things I look at straight away with a mass spectrograph. I look at the parent molecular ion peak, and I look at the base peak. Those are two things I care about. Nothing else yet. Okay? So number one, look at the parent molecular ion peak. Number two, look at the base peak. And if you're stuck, look at the lowest molecular weight peak. So I see that we've got, this is 41, this is 42. Remember, they have to be even numbers because they represent entire protons getting knocked off, right? 42, 43, 44. So the highest molecular weight is 44. So we have to ask ourselves, what kind of alkane would have a molecular weight or atomic mass of 44? I would say probably propane. Do you all agree? Propane is C3H8. And so what is the molecular weight of propane? This is all literally guess and check.
44.094.
Pardon?
44.094.
There you go. So straight away, we know this has to be propane. Can't be butane because butane's got four carbons. 4 times 12 is 48. It's already over 44, right? So it can't be butane. Chloropropane, chlorine is 35 protons. It's huge. Chloropropane would make the molecular weight like 70. Do you all agree? Can't be ethane. We know ethane is too small. And so by logical guess, straight away, your answer is propane. This is question 19 of a trial paper. Too easy. But that's how you quickly identify what a compound is. So mass spec is not that hard. But do you see the line of thinking that I had there? What's the parent molecular ion? What's the base peak? I try to guess what this is. So can you all try guessing what fragment this would be? So I see this is about 29. Do you all agree? And with 29, you think, well, what could make up 29? I think how many carbons and how many hydrogens would make up 29? Because remember, this is a fragment. It can be any number of carbons and hydrogens. Well, I know 2 carbons is 24. So it has to be 2 carbons. And then how many hydrogens do I need to add to get to 29?
5.
5, yeah. So you'd need to add 5 hydrogens. So what this fragment would be is simply this. And I just add an electron there because that's where it got ripped off or broken off propane. Yeah, so the most common fragment was formed when we broke off a methyl group off propane. And so 29 represents this fragment. And I actually remember that. There are a few fragments you should really remember. One of the fragments is this group, 29. 13 is a methyl fragment, I believe. Yeah. No, 15. Yeah.
Wait, so basically, all we're doing is basically matching the mass from the x-axis to what can most occur. Like
that's it. That's it. Oh. Exactly.
They're not too bad.
Yeah, they're not bad at all. I think mass spec is easy. And once you literally follow, what's a parent molecular ion? Get its compound name. What's the base peak? What could it be? And then you're done. It's that easy.
Okay.
Yeah, they'll always tell you the class of the compound. They can't. If they don't tell you this, it could be anything, right? It could be a carbonyl group with an ethene, could be an acid, could be anything. So they always tell you the class. So you just have to know the generalized formula and then start guessing carbons and hydrogens. That's how easy mass spec is. All right. All right, everyone. We'll stop it there. Tomorrow, next lesson, NMR. Okay?